everybody, and welcome back to Pro League here on Tuesday. My name is Valdez. With me tonight is Wolf. We got a picture. Wow, what a fantastic picture that was. Fantastic lighting.
We look so handsome there in that photo. But tonight, guys, it is a Freak of Freaks versus MVP in the last match before we go into playoffs. Now, for MVP, unfortunately, at 0-5 and -9, they have no chances of making it to the playoffs. However, Africa has one chance, but they have to get a 3-0 in order to advance.
Yeah, funnily enough, they're using Super here. They used him actually five times so far in all five games, but they're putting him out first on Runes of Saris to go up against Gumiho. Definitely one of the stronger members of Team MVP Chicken Maru. So this is going to be an explosive first game. As you said, Freak of Freaks have to get a 3-0. So that starts with Super here against Gumiho.
Yeah, Super, Curious, and Bomber. All three of them have to win their games. They cannot win to the 3-1. There was a lot of debate about this on the internet, but it's settled. If they actually get a 3-1, they tie with Samsung. But because they were defeated by Samsung, 3-0, in fact, they went 0-3 versus Samsung, they will not be able to be eligible because they lost in the direct comparison. Now, that particular match will definitely haunt Africa, because if they had won that, or even won with like a slightly better score, this would be a different situation. But as it is, they have to get a 3-0 today. And I find it very strange they're not fielding Alive today, because I feel like he's one of their best players right now.
Yeah, I really cannot understand that, Wolf. You were talking to some of the Korean commentators, and they said, oh, he's tired. He needs a break. He's been working pretty hard. But this is literally the most important match for them. If they make it into the playoffs, anything could happen. But
yeah,
for him not to play tonight, they must have a lot of confidence in these three guys.
That is indeed true. The playoff match is like so important for points going into the actual grand postseason. That's where you get the most of your points. You almost never see teams that don't make it to playoffs get even close to anywhere where the rest of the teams are, especially now we only have three rounds.
Yeah, that's very true. Here's where we stand so far. SKT at the top. Jin Air winning yesterday, in fact, and KT Rolster losing puts Jin Air Grooming's ahead at second. So KT Rolster is going to have to play an extra game against either Samsung Galaxy Con or against the Africa Freaks if they can pull off that 3-0.
Yep. So the only way, just to clarify, for them to win is 3-0 with the plus one indicator. They'll be at 3-3 with plus one. They'll have just 1 point ahead. Taking a look at our winners ranking here, you can see that Zest is all the way up at the top, 6-2. Maru just barely not making it there, 5-0. And looking at these two teams, nobody really involved in that top of the lineup.
Yeah, here is our lineup for today. Super versus Gumiho, Curious versus Departure. Then we go into Bomber versus Forte, and then our fourth match, Keen versus Ryung. We get to see Ryung tonight if it does go to that fourth matchup, but Africa Freaks are definitely hoping that it doesn't get there.
Yeah, for Chicken Maru here, it's basically all about their pride. Like, if they end up losing 0-3, yeah, it means Africa will advance, but they'll be, I believe, -12 if that happens. So
yeah, you're correct.
That's just, you never want to be down there. I mean, the thing is, MVP is a great team, and they have really good players this season. I'm surprised they're doing this poorly. It's like CJ, you know, without Coach Park, they just don't seem to be quite as strong as they were when they had him last year. I mean, he was leading their teams to constant victories. People were really shocked by that, but now I'm more shocked by the fact that they're doing so terribly.
Yeah, definitely one of the big stories of round one for this year is them not doing so well. They were able to win yesterday, in fact, against KT, I believe. So kind of some good in good spirits now. Unfortunately, it's not going to matter too much, but maybe they can build off of that into round two. But for our first matchup of the night, as we mentioned before, it's going to be Super versus Gumiho in a PVT on Runes of Saris.
Yeah, you guys can see that there's not a whole lot of data for these two players in this matchup this year at 0-1 and 1-1. But both of these players known to be good in the matchup in the past. I would say Gumiho's TVP the most incredible. I mean, everyone remembers the time where the booth fell on his head and he beat Zest.
Yep.
So
he gained superpowers. Yeah. Habitation Station somehow dropped him to death, just like the booth dropped on him.
Here they are, and this is going to be a sick match. Whoa. Only Monday Caster is going Super's way.
Yeah, that doesn't look too good for the Africa Freaks. They would definitely have liked some more votes, but the rest of us do go for Gumiho. I did lose my first place prediction spot tonight, hoping to gain that back and win that chicken prize. Hopefully, I'll get some of that delicious chicken Maru if I do get first. But either way, guys, let's jump into game number one right now, Super versus Gumiho. down here in the bottom right in the purple, the Protoss player. It is Super.
And his opponent to the top right. For MVP, it is Gumiho, a man who's found himself on many teams over the past few years, starting out on FoYu, where he's actually a random player, who then mained Zerg briefly and then finally decided on Terra, and he was still winning matches back in the old GSTL back then. And he's been on tons of teams even post-Kespa era, and now finds his home here on MVP as one of their star players, in fact. And he may be the one here to defeat Super and eliminate a Freak of Freaks from having that chance in the playoffs.
Wouldn't it be so depressing for the Freaks if Gumiho just started off with a win now and they're like, oh, okay, I guess we're just playing for fun now, essentially. Also, you know, for pride, they do, of course, want to win against the team that hasn't won a single game in the first round. That is, of course, MVP Chicken Maru.
Yeah. We saw, actually, when the players were on stage earlier, just that a Freak of Freaks was filled with smiles, laughter. It looks like they're going to this almost with a very light-hearted attitude, which is can be a good thing. Obviously, it kind of shows that this team is not too nervous or stressed by going into this matchup, but it also makes me worried that maybe they're too overconfident. I see one probe in the gas here briefly to get that Nexus up just a little bit faster. I'm going to put that second one in there.
Yeah, we do see Super going for an earlier scout here than Gumiho. Gumiho now sending out the SCV. But these guys aren't going to know that they are at close vertical spawns here for quite a while. We do see these two scouts coming out now. We do have the Reaper expand from Gumiho as well.
Yeah. And the probe is just all the way in the wrong place. And getting information he can. He's going to run to this SCV. And then Gumiho's going to know in just a moment what's going on. I guess at this point he thinks it's just a late scout, but it's not going to be the case. It's like, oh, getting freaked out. Is that a late Nexus? Is it one base? No. He's actually still seeing the Reaper this way first to intercept the probe. And will actually stop the probe from seeing anything.
Wow, he was really defensive with that grenade too. He's like, you're not getting anywhere near my base, probe. Don't even think about it. But back at the base of Gumiho, we do have an extra barracks coming down here. Yeah, as well as
that factory. And with the positions here, obviously Widow Mines could be quite powerful in drop form, even, you know, in a sort of Hellion action, not as popular these days, but that's very powerful when you're in these spawns on Saris, and he knows that now, and we'll see this Adept opening with the Nexus. And that Reaper just barely getting away.
Yeah, unfortunately wasn't able to get two shots there to finish him off. And this Mothership Core at very close positions. There is, in fact, only two Marines, so the Mothership Core can get a lot of damage here.
And Gumiho's not paying attention with those two Marines either. Perhaps he just wants to wait until he has more, because two won't be enough. But he's going to have to spend a lot of time repairing and spending money to do so. He's basically spending money to lose mining time right now. Finally, the Marine's coming over.
Oh, and he gets two SCVs so far. This Mothership Core is getting so much damage done just based off of the opening of Gumiho, of course, going into Reaper and then Reactor. You're not going to have a bunch of Marines for a very long time. So getting a nice bit of damage done there can just return home.
Yep, and those Gumiho even checks to see where the Mothership Core is with that Reaper so he can find the best way of jumping into the main base to get the scout off. The Robo and Twilight Council aren't finished now. He's going to sneak just past that Adept. Is it going to go for Harass here instead of going for the scout? Bit of a risky move, but we'll eventually get that scout off here. We'll see the Robo. Pylon gets overcharged, and he, I believe, just barely saw that Twilight Council.
Let me take a look here quickly.
Yeah, he did. Just see it. Just barely. But that's really common, so it's not enough information. He's actually going to follow up with the Hellion from that factory as well to try to do a little bit more harass. Some of these probes were damaged earlier from the Reaper grenade, and he's even going to force his way in here. He wants to see if that's a Prism coming out, and he might just barely get to see that if he lives a little bit longer.
Nice block there from the probe, but the Hellion is still going to get a full scout of the base. I love this follow-up. Reaper into Hellion, you're going to see everything. So he knows that it's chrono-boosted Blink out here. He sees the robotics facility, doesn't see the warp prism, but can definitely have some sort of idea that an aggression is coming here. But the stim is so late, only started now. A very big problem here for Gumiho. Does have this drop with the Widow Mines coming across, so maybe he can distract Super for a bit here.
Yeah, he definitely needs to do some damage. He's finding himself nearly 10 harvesters behind right now. The stim being behind is also a problem for more direct pressure coming up. He's done kind of like a hybrid build from factory tech to bio, so he's getting a quicker stim than you normally would, but obviously his factory tech is not as powerful because of that. who just barely misses this. Widowmine will force a pull here, but the Marines are going towards the main base.
Yeah, really nice pull. We do see the the medevac just going to fly away. In fact, looks like a scan went down here to snipe an observer. But Drop really not getting all that much damage done. Just forcing a pull and getting one probe, so not bad.
Dark Shrine coming up here as the observers go full buddy system over there. just totally rallied there, wasn't paying attention. This Drop will scout the third base. And we do have a big move out here with Blink Stalkers. And this game is totally controlled by Super right now. He's not afraid of anything. He could actually aggressively blink in. He has full vision right now of this base. You going to target down the medevac?
Targets down the medevac, and now he can get right on the edge here. The lip blink down to the low ground and get a ton of damage done here. There is a nice concave of Marines, so it is going to push him back. And at the same time, this third base is going to be denied, it looks like, as no warprints are coming over. Yeah, there's the cancel.
Yeah, it doesn't look like he has a pylon nearby, so we'll have to remake that. But a few units coming over now to help out. But again, I feel like Super is totally controlling this game. He still has Stalkers here now to pressure the natural. Just going to blink above that bunker and take out some of these SCVs. Even the engineering bay is vulnerable here. He's going to lose that, it looks like. Forcing these Marines down. And the Nexus is not being denied this time at the third.
Not going to commit to getting that engineering bay. That would have been so nice. Would have denied any missile turrets from coming down, as there are none just yet with the DT follow-up. Here's another nice drop, though, from Gumiho into the main. There's no defense over here. Where's the Mothership Core? He's just going to have to pull.
Yeah, it looks like he is lacking units there. The Mothership Core finally comes from, it looks like, the natural here. And Green Commentators went crazy there, but actually the medevac is fine. DTs do get warped in to help defend this as well. They won't be necessary. And we do see the transition into Double Forge and Supreme late game here for Super, as his Nexus is about to be mining. But Gumiho still hasn't found any damage here. He finally has the stim. He doesn't have combat shields yet. And the DTs are going to start harassing. Looks like the first one's going to hit the natural. The turret is just about ready.
And it's getting there. Super is going to delay just a bit and allow Gumiho to finish up. It looks like he wants to do some blink pressure at the same time. So kind of misses that small timing.
Yeah, it looks like he's just going to poke from the low ground, but there is a siege tank here that's going to deny that. With good blink micro, though, he should be fine. He's losing way too many stalkers, however. He's microing his DTs meanwhile. It looks like that's what he was focusing on there, that warp prism instead.
Yeah. So, yeah, I mean, the blink not doing much, the DT's not doing much. Really all it's doing is keeping Gumiho on two base for a very long time. And the Nexus is done. It's been mining for about a minute now. He's got the robot, the double forge, so I feel like Super is in a pretty good spot as long as he can defend any kind of two base push coming from Gumiho. We do have reactored out liberators on the way, more tanks, and a lot of marauders, too, to deal with the stalkers on the ground.
Yeah, I think the two-base push you're talking about is exactly what Super is worried about right now. It's the only thing he needs to defend. He also scouted. He's had two observers in these bases the entire game, and he knows there's no third CC. He knows he's massively ahead in eco, so he just needs to survive this next push, and he wins the game. He's trying to get this wasted scan here. Almost kills the observer. He's trying to get Adept attack speed out because that's going to make this a lot easier. He wants to slow down this push by harassing it with these Blink Stalkers and Adepts.
Yeah, he wants to force the stim here, and that he does. It looks like he's just going to go for the fight, force the tank to siege up, and then back off. Takes a bit of losses there, but he's buying himself a lot of time for the upgrades to finish up, the attack speed upgrade, everything that you were saying, more Immortals to come out, and that third base is just getting more and more value the more time he buys.
Now, I worry for Gumiho here. He started plus one armor and added two more barracks, so it looks like he wants to just kind of keep pressuring and then eventually hit with 1-1, but already 2-2s on the way, so he's not going to have an upgrade advantage. He's already got a disadvantage. They do a big aggressive drop here towards the main base, though. There's tons of Protoss units ready for it, however.
Yeah, he is waiting right here. There's no way you can drop in there with that many Blink Stalkers. The Mothership Core in position. Super is so confident, he's taking a fourth base right now. He's like, okay, you're never going to be able to pressure that. That's so far away from Gumiho.
Yeah. Glaives are done. That means the Adepts just got a ton more useful, especially dealing with these light units, these Marines. Having to use another scan here when you're on two base. You don't have that many harvesters. That's pretty expensive. It's very painful to do. He does have a third CC on the way. He's trying to mount this transition to a late game, but he's so far behind that I really worry for him here. He needs to get some sort of miracle engage, or this game's already over.
Yeah, we do have the Adepts shading in. And at the same time, the drop is going to come onto the high ground. Does not commit to the shade. It looks like he just wants to come into the main first and defend the drop.
Yeah, well, this is a good engagement point for Gumiho because the siege tanks are sieged up on the low ground protecting this army, plus he has the liberation zones to back this up. This could be the miracle engage he needs to actually win this trade to start getting him back into the game. He's going to even now elevator those tanks into the main base. Looks like he's considering it. Knows that Super lost his observers. He's constantly having to use hallucination scouts even to see the positioning.
Yeah, a couple of overcharges coming down here as Gumiho pokes forward with just a small group of units. He's taking this very, very slow as he does get that third orbital up and running. Yeah. At the same time, I'm not sure if he should be taking these trades. I mean, he's catching pylons, but he's losing very crucial units right now.
He, like, forgot the Dark Shrine doesn't need power to actually be effective. He really wants to get rid of it because he doesn't have any SCVs here. Oh, man, Super accidentally shot that for a second.
Taking a big couple of shots from tanks, too.
He's okay. Actually going to commit to this engage. There's, I mean, a lot of range units on the high ground. He's just going to try to burst this back.
Oh, man, he's just got enough stuff. 2-2 finished up for Super. And he just rolled over that army. Even though it was kind of an ugly engage, he just had way too many units.
Yeah. And even though Adepts don't have, like, massive amount of range, they're still ranged enough to deal with those tanks on the high ground. He has to pick up and leave. And now Gumiho secures a third base just in time for Super's fourth base to be ready. The 2-2 upgrades you just mentioned, they're finished. And it's 2-2 to 1-1 right now in upgrades. Gumiho's trying to use these tankabacks to find some amount of damage. But it's just negligible. He needs to do more. Okay, he's got a lot more units in these drops, so this could be a lot of damage.
Yeah, here come a bunch of Adepts, but look at all those units. And the Adepts getting clumped up and taking huge shots from the tanks. Will it be enough, though, to stop this? It looks like maybe just barely here. It will be. And, in fact, Gumiho is going to back off.
Super has so much army that he's actually, like, that was only, like, a third of his army. He's sending the rest of his army across the map in two groups to go kill Gumiho. His third base is under fire right now, but he could just run the probes away to his fourth base, which is what he's done here, and I think he has enough units to actually go over and save that. A lot of probes did go down unnecessarily. It looks like Super is just going to regroup and go home. This Nexus getting very low, and I think he might just barely lose it.
No, just not enough stuff. Just barely getting down to about 100 health there was the Nexus, but at the same time, another drop into the main. Gumiho really trying to pull Super apart at this point.
Yeah, this is what Gumiho is famous for and has been famous for since the beginning of time, is just simply never leaving games when he's behind, always trying to find an in back, and usually that's with drops and smart, you know, multitasking here. There's so many medivacs that he's just trading versus this Protoss army as well as he can, and is now just gonna have to boost out, but he's killing every unit he can, trying to get the maximum potential value out of these units.
Yeah, medevacs barely surviving. Very dangerous to do that against Blink Stalkers, but Gumiho finds a way. Again, he definitely is behind here, as it is now essentially 1.5 mining bases here for Gumiho to about 2.5 for Super. Got a nice little drop coming in here with the Warp Prism.
Yeah, just getting two SCVs, hey, it's something. He's even going to try to drop these Marines out to kill the Warp Prism. And Super deftly escapes. I don't think he has any Liberators left. He's making two right now, so he can't even go and finish that Warp Prism off right now.
Yeah, he's got none.
So that Warp Prism is so annoying for him. It also is a scary potential finisher in this game for Warpins to actually just attack and kill Gumiho. This is the first time in a while where Gumiho doesn't have any drops on the map. He's not actually pressuring at all. It's like an SCV over there. That's not doing anything. And now he has to just sit back and try to defend and not die.
Yeah, and it looks like Gumiho's thinking about going for the counterattack, but no, he's just going to try to fight here. Half his units are in the orange and yellow. He's having trouble, in fact, healing everything up. He's going to be able to snipe this Warp Prism, it seems, and get one of these Liberators in position, but Super just decides to go and deny more mining. Go straight for the main.
He wants to go for the throat, and Gumiho's going to try to base trade, it looks like. There's not a lot of Blink Stalkers on the map, and the ones that are on the map are getting killed right now, so these medevacs give supreme mobility to Gumiho because there's no way to kill them. There's no Stalkers to blink forward and finish them. He's making a ton right now because he has so much money.
Look at all these Blink Stalkers and all these units. The buy are so low. It is still 2-2 to 1-1, but just barely. Gumiho holding on super smartly, I believe. Does decide to turn all the way back around because this is the last remaining army for Gumiho.
I'm not messing with you guys when I say he had no Blink Stalkers. He just did two Warpins and had 16 that fast because he has unlimited money because he's had so many bases. Every Marauder is in the red. They all have like less than one health. They'll have like two-thirds of one hit point left. And that's going to be game here. He's up 100 supply. Gumiho does not want to leave it, but it's over.
Yeah, he's trying his best to deny Afrika the dream of making it into the playoffs if they can get that 3-0. He does land over here and drop about 7 mules, but he really does not have much production. You can see he's not making anything right now. It does
queue up seven Marines,
but that's not going to do much against this Protoss army.
He has a few mules. He only has 20 harvesters, and he's got 7 mules on the map right now. That's what's giving him enough money to make these Marines, but that's all he's got. That's his only income. And it's not going to last much longer. Look at this flimsy army, if you could even call it that. GG.
That's going to be it. We do have Super taking the first game, and that's game number one of three in a row that they do need. And funnily enough, only Chaser did believe in the Afrika dream.
That's right. All
other six casters believed that, in fact, Afrika was going to be shut down today because we voted for Gumiho.
You're absolutely right. And that was great start here for Afrika. I feel like that's one of their toughest matchups of the three they have to win.
Yeah.
Now they have to win a ZVZ, though. And that can always get crazy. All it takes is one misstep. There's so many build order losses, even in Legacy of the Void, that can happen in that matchup. But even still, I feel like this was the scarier one. And it shows in the caster predictions. 6 out of 7 said they thought Gumiho was ruining the dream. I talked to Korean commentators actually in the makeup room before this too, and I was like, does anyone think they've got what it takes? And everyone was like, no way, absolutely not.
Yeah, just real talk. But Afrika trying to prove us all wrong. That was the first step. Curious is still a pretty good ZVZ player. I would give him the lead here against Departure, but I know a lot of the other casters did vote for Departure. What do you think?
It's really tough for me, to be honest. I felt like I've been in Departure's corner this season. You guys have probably been following my predictions. And I do like his play, and I do like his ZVZ, but I think I have to go with Curious today. He's just been more consistent. He's been more solid. Departure has shown some great games. I think he's on the way to becoming